Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Tracks Off Grid. Well, we've got some more stuff done on the Beast this week, so let's take a look. Take a walk inside here and you guys can see what we've been working on. This is a very, very simple open floor plan. We are very happy with the way things are turning out. Like I told you everyone last week, we went ahead and got a lot of the walls and prefabrication done on some of the mock-up parts we got to put in. You know, we got the stove all mocked up and in place. It's a perfect spot for it. We actually have a cabinet that's going to go in here with the sink base, and it will give them a lot of extra storage underneath, and we're going to build some storage down here. We also got the mock-up for the fridge going in place, and this is a great little fridge for the client. It's going to work out well for what their needs are. It also will give them a little bit extra counter space right here. And then this whole area here is going to be kind of a day bed or a sitting area or maybe for their pet or whatever it be. But also underneath that, we're going to do our water tanks, our heater, our hot water heater, our electrical systems. And then again, we're going to run our chases like we did in Optimus up along the roof lines and stuff to make ease of ability for servicing down the road later on. So everything's coming to plan so far. Like I said, very open floor place. There's going to be nothing here in this area, and there's a good reason for it. I'll get to that in just a little bit, but let's take a walk towards the bathroom. And as you can see, the door is going to go in this area right here. I really like the way the client decided to do this. They actually put the window inside the bathroom, which will help with ventilation, lighting, and so forth. We're still going to attach a ventilation fan up on the roof, but this is makes it a little bit bigger of a bathroom. We're still going to have a wet bath. The toilet will be inside of it. It's right about here, so we'll have an outside access for the cassette. And then again, back here will be a seating area for their, you know, dining or whatever it be. And then again, the Happy Jack will come out of the bed, the ceiling, and come down, and they'll be able to utilize that. So to get back to this open area, and again, they are going to put a fold-down counter over here for some extra area if they need it for cooking or whatever it be. But this area back here behind the windows, we had to pull those out to get some materials in here. That is a door that we're going to be cutting in, and that's going to allow for the client to put their kayaks or canoes in this entire area. Again, great idea. New stuff to us, you know, and again, great ideas come from a lot of people thinking and putting their thoughts together, and that's going to work out well for them. So that's going to be something we're going to definitely incorporate into some more future builds down the road. But again, this is coming together real nicely. We'll have this thing finished framed up here not too long from now. We'll actually start putting in the shower pan, which you already have built, and we'll get the tile in, we'll get the walls in and so forth, and get this thing buttoned up, the lighting, the electrical and so forth. A very simplistic build, and these are the fun ones because you get done really fast and the client is able to use their vehicle as quick as possible. So, you know, things are moving along, like I told everyone, and we'll keep bringing out some good videos of this build for the Beast so you all can see the progress and how easy this is going to be and how, again, simplistic it is for living and so forth. So let's take a walk over here. I wanted to share something with you guys. We are actually putting together a rack for a client, but we are also going to now have a do-it-yourself roof rack kit for the trucks. And with that being said, I will be posting some pictures of our do-it-yourself kit on our Instagram and on our homepage with our online store. So you can reach out to us. It's info@tracksoffgrid.com or check out tracksoffgrid.com. Has all the contact information on there. You can get a hold of us. We'll let you know what the price is. That will save some people some money. We have one we're picking up here in just a little bit from the coating company that put a coating on the rack for them. It's actually like a bedliner type material that they put onto the rack for them. Came out really nice, and then that's getting shipped out next week up to the northeastern part of the country. So we're pretty psyched about that, but again, the kit will come with everything you need, and we can palletize it to make it easier for shipping and send it right out to you. So there's one other thing I wanted to share with everyone. I'm going to take a walk outside in front of the shop here. Is this little guy right here. We picked this up the other day. This is a build for a client, and we are starting to venture into some of the van stuff. This is unique, though. This is a Japanese JDM right-hand drive Toyota Light Ace turbo diesel, and it's four-wheel drive. I've been driving this thing around for the last few days just to make sure and check it out. The client asked me to make sure everything's running great on it. Peppy little truck, if you want to call it a truck, or peppy little van. There is a ton of room in this thing. Let's take a quick walk around here. And again, the layout is so cool in this thing. We are pretty happy about this little thing. We can't wait to do it. These seats actually spin completely around, or you can spin them individually and you can face the person behind you. There's another set of seats back here that fold up, and you can make more room if you're just going to use it for transporting stuff or whatever. But all that's actually coming out except for these seats. We're going to figure out a way to incorporate those still into the build, or they may have to go. But this is going to be a fun little overlander. It's going to get a rack. It's going to get an actual snorkel. And the reason for the snorkel is they just actually want a little bit better airflow into the vehicle so it gets better gas mileage. But this thing is just way cool. I mean, I can't say enough cool things about this thing. It came from the boat. We've got actually three more of these things getting showing up to us for some other clients. But again, guys, keep watching our videos, and you're going to see some pretty cool stuff come out of this. And I'm sorry I got tongue-tied there for a minute. But again, hit the subscribe, hit the like button if you haven't, hit that little bell. Be sure to stay tuned. We'll be getting some really cool things coming out of the shop here real soon. And again, you guys have a great weekend. Thank you again for the new subscribers that have come on. We look forward to the comments and the the appreciation that we get from people in emails and so forth. But again, guys, have a great weekend. Thanks for all your support, and we'll be talking to you soon. Thanks.